If there's a desperate situation and a wife decides to go get a job and support financially or do on her own, that's a voluntary thing she's doing that she cannot be told to do. And if she does that, if she does get a job, if she does have a business, if her father left behind some stores or some property in her name, and you're like, hey, can we get some of that too? Because I'm your family. No, that's her money. You can't touch it. Allah made this equation in which she has a financial advantage, meaning your money is basically hers. And her money is hers. And you can't look at it. You can't keep your eye on it. You can't say, whatever happened to that? What happened to that jewelry? What happened to that? No, that's not yours to touch. That's not yours to touch. And whatever you gave her, like you say, hey, you know, on our 10th anniversary, I'm going to give you this car. That, you know, once you gave her the car, it's her car. It's her. You can't even take the keys and say, I'm going. No, you got to get her permission. And she better give it on her own good free will. No pressure, not even unspoken pressure that you could touch that car. Because you gave it up, it's done. It's done. وَآتُ النِّسَاءَ صَدُقَاتِهِنَّ نِحْلَةً. Give women their gifts happily and freely. Don't even think about them again. Don't even think about them again. So this financial sense that men are supposed to have is critical. And Allah mentions that as one of the first conditions of what makes a marriage work.